This has been a really long battle for the Freedmen here in Oklahoma, just trying to get the services that they believe they deserve. But when it comes to the pandemic, they thought they'd be in the clear.
You're now telling a group of people that is about a fourth of the tribe to go ahead and die because you don't even want to give us a shot.
Freedmen citizen of the Seminole Nation, Lietta Osborne-Sampson, allegedly denied when she tried to get a COVID-19 shot at the Indian Health Services Clinic in Wewoka using her tribal ID.
It says 00 Indian blood, and it says Freedmen, and I was a citizen. And they told me that they do not recognize their citizens there.
It's been a years-long battle for the Freedmen, who were once owned as slaves by the Seminoles.
We all have fought the same fight. We all have shed the same blood to be called Seminoles.
Lawsuit after lawsuit, finally establishing the Freedmen are full tribal citizens in 2003. But Lietta's alleged story, proof they're still being denied services.
I sent us a denial letter saying that we had the wrong poet.
Anthony Connolly says it happened to him, too.
A lot of my family members have died, passed away. You know, waiting to get, you know, health services and stuff like that.
Both Conley and Lietta have sat on the Seminole Nation Tribal Council for over 10 years. They're working with other Freedmen right now on yet another legal battle.
We're trying to pull together $10,000 for the lawyer that we have chosen to go back into federal court to try to resolve this situation.
The Indian Health Services sending News 4 a statement saying, in part, the Oklahoma City area Indian Health Service is not involved in determining tribal enrollment of individual citizens. And the chief of the Seminole Nation saying, any allegation that the Seminole Nation is denying access of the COVID-19 vaccine to a group of people is entirely false.
In a pandemic, you would think that the tribe would look beyond our color, beyond the ethnic of what you call us, and see the people that we are a part of this nation.
In Wewoka, Jessica Bruno, Oklahoma's News 4.